Welcome back to this video lecture series on programming questions for placement preparation. Today the problem we'll be seeing is known as find the next greater palindrome. So let's have a look at the problem statement first. It says given a number as a character type array, find the next greater number which is a palindrome. So basically we'll be given a number and we'll have to use a character type array to solve the problem. So either the number is given as an integer or it is already given as a character type array, we will have to use that character type array. So for example, if the given number is 152, we should be printing the output as 161. So let's have a look at the approach. So we'll first take the number given as a character type array and we'll convert it to integer and add 1 to it. Then we will convert the increased number back to character type array. Now we'll run a loop, a while loop, till the increased number is a palindrome. Whenever we find that the number in the current iteration is a palindrome, we'll go out of the loop. So for finding a number's palindrome, what we'll do, we'll take the number represented as a character type array, and from the middle of the array, we'll replace the second half of the array with the reverse of the first half of the array. That is the actual way of palindrome. So we'll check whether all the elements of the first half is in a reverse order in the second half. If it is so, then we'll say yes, it is a palindrome, and we can then terminate the while loop. And after loop termination, we'll print the number as a character type array. So let's jump onto the programming part and see how we can implement it. So here what I'm going to do first is I'm going to take the number as an integer only, and let's say I'll take the value of this number from the user. So cin num, and then I'll use some functions. So first thing we need to do is we need to convert this integer into a character type array. So I'll use a function to array, and I'll pass this a number here, right? Or rather number plus 1 will do, because the current number is already given. We'll have to check for the next greater palindrome. So let me define this to array function first. So the return type will be void, and let's say I've got this num as argument. So for this I'll take global character type array. So let's name it S, and let's say its size is 30. So first what I'm going to do, I'm going to take an I equals to 0, and I'm going to run a loop while the num is not 0 basically. So S of I will be is equal to num ampersand 10 plus 0. So this particular line here will convert the integer to a character, right? And then we'll say num equals to num divided by 10, and lastly I plus plus. So after we terminate the loop, what we will find is that I will be the size of this array, and the next thing is that the array here, let's say the number is 152. So in the array, what we will see, the numbers are 2, then 5, and then 1. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to reverse the array. So let's now reverse the array. So I'll first check if the number of elements in the array is odd or even, then I'll take actions according to it. So let's first check for if it is even. So if this is even, what we'll do, I'll take two integers, let's say m, and that will be m I by 2, and let's take another integer n, which will be m minus 1. So what I'll do, I'll run a loop here while m is less than I and n is greater than is equals to 0. I'll take let's say t, a variable. Let me first store s of n here, then in s of n store the s of m. S of m will have t. So now after we are done with this, what we will do is we will terminate the string or the character array with a null character. So s of m is equal to this. Okay, also here I'll have to increase the loop, so m plus plus and n minus minus. Okay, same thing will need to be done for odd number of elements. So paste the code here. This will not be if, this will be else now, and I'll need to have this, and let me say this will be I by 2 minus 1. Okay, so here we are. Now we will run a loop while not is palindrome this current number, because s is a global variable, so I can use it a global character type array. So I'll define this function is palindrome later. What I'll do in this while loop is that if we see that it is not a palindrome, then we'll convert this string into an integer, we'll increase it by 1, and then again back to character type array to check whether it is a palindrome or not in the loop again. So let me first do what. I'll take a variable n and I'll convert to number this string, then I'll increase the value of n by 1, and then again I'll use this toArray function to convert the number to a character type array. So before defining the isPalindrome function, I'll first define this toNum function. So this basically will return an integer, and here the argument is a character type array. So I'll first need to compute the size of the character type array. So while, okay, let me initialize with 0, s of n is not is equals to null character, I'll do what, n plus plus. So I've got the size of the string. Now I run a loop, a for loop, int I is equals to n minus 1, I is greater than equals to 0, I minus minus. I'll have to construct the number. So for that, int num, which will start with the value of 0, then int, I'll take a multiple which will be used. So I'll first do what is that num plus is equal to mul into the current character of the array. This is a character, so let me convert it to an integer by doing this, and that will be okay. And then I'll increase this mul by 10 times, so it will be like this. So lastly, the number I'll get, number that was stored as a character type array. So I'll return the num, right? So lastly, I'll need to define this is palindrome function. So again, let me define it here. The return type will be boolean, so here it is. again a character type array. So how to do it? Again, I'll take this and I'll use this piece of code to compute the size of the string, and I'll have to check if the size is odd or even, then I'll take the actions accordingly. So if n ampersand 2 is 0, then well, this is almost same as this, so let me just copy it here. Okay, so for ease, I'll replace this n here with I. So now I'll do while s of m is equal to s of n. I'll do m plus plus and n minus minus. So now if this n value reaches after the loop terminates, and if it is a palindrome, then this n value will reach minus 1 value or less than 0, and this m value will reach a value which is equal to the size of the array. So if n is less than 0 and m is equals to I, then what we will do, will return true, otherwise will return false. Okay, so again almost same thing to be done for odd number of elements. So let me just copy it here and I'll use an else here. This will be I by 2 minus 1, this will be plus 1. Okay, so this is the isPalindrome function. So now lastly, what I'll do is that cout next greater palindrome is the s. So that is it. Let's now run this code. So let's put 152 as the input value. So the expected output should be 161. So let's check. Well, you can see the result comes as the next greater palindrome is 161. So that was done properly, the way in which we can actually find the next greater palindrome of a given number. Thank you for watching this video and staying with us. See you next time.